Hello, everybody. It's Chappy K. Kendall here, and this is my husband, Jonathan. We know WebEx the other day with our AHA meeting was a little rough, and the sound cut in and out for a lot of people, and my video wasn't working. So I wanted to make this quick little introduction video of five fast facts about Chappy K, and some of them about Jonathan, to make up for the fact that the WebEx meeting wasn't ideal. So, fast fact number one, and why it matters to you. This is what our faces look like, guys. Good to see you. Obviously, we want you to know what we look like because when we see you, we want to say hi and we want you to feel comfortable saying hi to us. Obviously, when we see you out and about on campus, we'll be masked up, so you only see our eyes and some other things about us. But my kind of dead giveaways are that A, I'm like probably one of the shortest humans you've ever met. So if you see a short person, probably me. I've got my name badge. I don't wear it all the time, but I try to wear it most of the time just because it helps, especially with the mask thing. And this is like my signature hairstyle. I've got this like kind of thick, long, curly mess going on. So the half up, half down, sometimes with a bow or a bandana to distract you from everything that's happening. That's my go-to, depending on the day, of course, of the hair. All my curly hair people, they know what's up. fast fact number two, we love food. And since we mentioned the great burger list, and we know that you're gonna get tired of Mimo, we get tired of Mimo, don't we? Yeah. We wanted to go ahead and let Jonathan tell you the top five burger places for you to try in Waco. You wanna let him know?
Hi, I'm John. I'm going to tell you the top five burger places in Waco. The fifth is not going to be hugely new for those of you in Texas, but being from Cincinnati, it was definitely new to me. It's Whataburger is coming in at number five. Fortunately, we have two locations nearby, one in the grease pit right across from us in that construction mess that's going on in 35. I always like to get it with jalapenos, so if you're a number four person, you're my kind of person. Number four is Cups Drive-In, which is on our side of the highway. It's not far from VTex and Fuego's Tacos. It's really good. Health Camp, right in the circle, has good burgers as well, and you can get good shakes.
Definitely recommend the shakes.
Number two is Twisted Root. If you're into any sort of exotic meat, from buffalo to ostrich, they have that. Of course, they have the famous Freshman 15, which, as your first year, you may be interested in getting. It's worth your money. I don't know if it's worth the caloric count, but that's honestly a personal call. And then finally, the best in Waco is a hole-in-the-wall place called Double R, DUBL-R. They sponsor a little league field in town, so they care about their community, and they also make a really good burger. Is that all you need from me?
Yep, that's all I need from you. Thanks
All
for
right.
joining us.
Nice to see you all. I'll be see you in the lobby or somewhere else. Bye.
All right, and that's my husband, everybody. He's great. All right, so the reason I brought up the fact that we love food and why that matters to you is because part of what I do is hang out with you guys while we get food. Let me know if you want to grab a meal sometime for a one-on-one, or I have a little coffee card. I don't have a lot of coffee money. But sometimes I can get you coffee. Just let me know. We can set something up. Because I know you're gonna want the coffee sometimes. So, moving right along, fast fact number three. I love questions. Guys, I'm just such a nerd. I can't help it. I love to think about anything and everything, and it's just my favorite. So, why does that matter to you? Well, it's quite simple, my friends. I do all of my asynchronous, what I'm calling my asynchronous programming, which is on my WordPress account. All of that is based off of questions. Questions that I have about faith, questions that you have about faith, and you put in the faith question box that's up at the front desk in the lobby. Any of that stuff is going to be rooted in the questions that we have of life and of faith, and just opportunities for me to explore and possible answers, because a lot of times there's not just one, but possible answers to these questions, alongside you and alongside like Baylor professors and local pastors, just to try to figure out, what is this life all about and what is my faith and what are my values and my beliefs. So I encourage you to check out the Chatty Chappy K WordPress, its blogs and podcasts that you can look at whenever you have time to really grow your faith alongside your Collins community, even from the privacy and the safety of your own room. So that's a great tool that I want you to be able to use. Again, it's a WordPress account. The account's Chatty Chappy K. And if you're ever on my board, that's outside of my room in First North, there is a QR code you can scan that'll take you right to that web page. Fast fact number, is this four already? Wow, we are going through these so fast. I've called a lot of places home. Jonathan has called a lot of places home. I'm originally from a town called Frankfort, Kentucky. It's actually the capital of Kentucky, but let me tell you, it's a small town. It's actually smaller than Waco, which for some of you is like, whoa, it gets smaller than Waco. It does, my friends. It does. But all that being said, that's only one of the places I've called home. I've also called a place called Georgetown, Kentucky, my home. And that's where I went to school and went to undergrad. And that's where I got to meet Jonathan at a Halloween party, of all things. And then I've called Oxford, the University of Oxford in England. That was my home for a semester when I studied abroad. It's a very different place than any other place I've called home, but it was also a place that challenged me and allowed me to grow in a really cool way. I've called Waco home. Waco has been my home for 3 years, y'all. 2 years here at Baylor, and 1 year before that when I was teaching with Waco ISD. And again, I like to dot like. I like to, make jokes about Texas and how it's not as great as Kentucky, which I mean is true. But honestly, Texas has been a great home to me. Waco has really received me with big arms. It's really been a great place for me in this season of life. And just as I have called many places home, some of you have called many places home. Even if Waco was just your second home, that's still a big thing. And home is important to us. Home is a place that is safe. A home is a place where we feel rooted and grounded. It's the place where we first learn about what is important to us and what we believe. And then when we kind of get uprooted, like our first year at a new place like Waco, it's also a place where we have to pause and really think, like, what is it about home that I want to keep? Or what is it about this new home that, like, I like and I want to incorporate into my life. I just think the idea of home is so important, which is why I do this like synchronous online Zoom program called Hometown Highlights. It's going to be the second and fourth week of every month, and it's going to be an opportunity for us to get together and for us to talk about a home, one hometown of one resident at a time, and for us to explore like what is similar about their home than is mine, what's different, and how is God challenging me to like, in this tension of what is the same and what is different, how is God challenging me to grow in those spaces, and to be more of the person that God has called me to be? Because I think home, and these conversations about home really are opportunities for God to teach us and to sanctify us, as we challenge our ideas and our beliefs, and grow deeper even in them sometimes as we hold on to what is good from our previous home. So again, hometown highlights, home. It's a great thing. I hope you join in the conversation because I want to know more about what you call home. And I want to be challenged by you just as much as you are challenged by me. And then finally, but certainly not least, fast fact number five. I'm a graduate student. So I'm actually only a part-time worker. I work 20 hours a week. And then I am a graduate student full-time, and I'm a dual degree student. So I go to Truett Seminary, which is Baylor Seminary, and I'm getting a Master's of Divinity. For those of you who are like, seminary, what's that? Excellent question. Seminary is like the professional degree for pastors, or people who are wanting to go into ministry of some sort. So we study a lot of theology and the Bible, but we also study very practical classes. Literally, you learn how to baptize someone, because if you don't know how to do it right, you're gonna drown them, which would be awkward. So we do a lot of stuff like that too. So it's like how to do ministry and how to do it well. So that's one of my degrees, but my other degree, because I'm a dual degree student, is getting a master's of social work. And I particularly am training to work in this intersection of faith and like social justice and advocacy and that kind of work, and how our faith really fuels how we help and like work in our community. That is what I'm really passionate about, and that is why I love this job so much. To be a resident chaplain is to work at this really interesting intersection, because I get to provide pastoral care to you guys. I get to meet you where you are, which sometimes means I get to do cool Bible studies and really dive into like the word and stuff with you. But also for some of you, like you have a different faith journey or you have a different need. Maybe some of you are just having a rough time and you need to get connected to some resources like the counseling center. I can help you do that. Maybe some of you just need someone to sit with you in your grief and in your loss, without trying to figure out the faith thing because it's just too complicated right now to think about how God fits into that grief. And that's okay. I can sit in those spaces with you, just to be there and to be alongside you. For some of you, you might need any other number of resources, and I'm here to help you connect with those, and to empower you, as a child of God. So those are five fast facts about me, and why they matter to you and to what I do here. I look forward to getting to know each and every one of you more this year. I know it's a weird year, and you're probably tired of hearing people say that. But I challenge you, no matter how weird this year is, we're gonna get through it together. And I would love to connect with you. So in any of the number of ways that we can connect together, I look forward to meeting you more, this year. Ciao, ciao for now. Catch you later.